Hi, I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. I got a bonus video. When you looked at my Qt creator in the previous example, or in the previous video, you would see that it highlights my blocks. So you can see the rectangle here is highlighted in slightly whiter color than the gray background-ish. If I highlight over here, I can see the extent of this rectangle. That's, and I also have these markers here on the site that I can expand and collapse. That's a nice feature in Qt Creator. Let me just show you what I did to enable that. So in Qt Creator, Alt-C for the Tools menu, and go down to Options. It's underneath Text Editor, Display. And over here you will find the highlight blocks. That's the highlighting of my current block. If you do not like it and it's on by default, then tick that one off. And if it's not on by default and you think that it'll be a useful feature for you, then put it on. And similar, we have the highlighting of, or the markers in the site somewhere in here. Well, I cannot find it right now, but you'll find it eventually, I'm sure. So anyway, Tools, Option, and Text Editor, and you'll find a lot of very nice customization that you can do to your text editor. And this completes the end of this first module on programming with Qt and QML. In the next module, we're going to see how we can create user interfaces using images. You'll see that a lot of user interfaces is actually a bunch of images put on top of each other in creative ways. We will talk about transformations, which is allowing us to take those images and rotate them or scale them or some other things that will make them look in exactly the way that we would like. In the previous video, I told you that you're not going to put down your X and Y and width and height all over the place. You'll likely work with layout managers. And we're going to see the first layout manager in QML that we have, the anchor layout. We're going to see that in the next module too. And finally, we're going to talk about the colors and the gradients in QML. I will show you how you can set that up. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel here so that you'll be notified as soon as those videos come out. Thank you very much for watching so far. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB.